Hi everyone, my name is Carla Sumarlidson and welcome to my studio. I'm here today to talk a little bit about my work and share some of my recent projects with you about what I do in my isolated practice. So a little bit about me. I am a painter and I've been doing art my whole life. It's been in the last few years that I've been really focusing on my practice. And I do these very large scale paintings that have to do with the human experience, social conditions, and other issues in our society. I'm going to tell you a little bit about some of the paintings and the work that I have here in the studio. This one's called Only Seafoods, and it has to do with hunger in our society when it's really not necessary. The food, the only sign comes from a place, a cafe on Hastings Street, East Hastings. So as you can see, I like to use neon signs from Vancouver. This one's called The Smiling Buddha. 1 versus 99, which has to do with Occupation Vancouver and privilege. And this cabaret was actually one that my dad played trumpet in many years ago in a big band. So as you can see, neon signs are very important in my work. I like to use neon signs because I remember as a child walking down Granville or Hastings Street with my grandfather and just looking at all the bright lights that were very enticing. That painting there, that one's called The Yale, Stuck in the Blues. And that one is about violence against women. This painting here was one I did not that long ago, but the conception came when Donald Trump was running for president. So I thought about it, about all the anguish that the public was showing, continues to show to this day. And it's called I Got You Cornered, Trump, Get a Clue. And as you can see on the table are the items from the game Clue. But there's a mad crowd outside and you don't know if they're mad about Trump being elected or if they're actually supporters of his election. This most recent painting here is the Jack Chow Insurance Building in Chinatown, and it has to do with human sacrifice. As you can see, there's a sign there that the Chinese had to pay head tax in order to come into Canada. These two women here are my Shanghai girls. And they're being sacrificed to the dragon. It deals with human trafficking and sex trafficking. And then over here, we have some things that I'm working on right now. And what I like to do with my artwork is tell a visual story and take the viewer on a personal journey. My pieces focus on social issues and the human condition faced particularly by women. This piece here, this sculpture that I'm going to show you is called Our Wedding Dress. I was going through my parents' belongings when I found my mother's wedding dress. I actually wore this to my first wedding. I took the dress quickly without thought and put it into my storage locker. I couldn't bring myself to throw it away, even though I really wanted to, because it just did not hold any good memories for me. When the hashtag MeToo movement started to take momentum, I had a revelation that I wanted to personify these atrocious truths. I used the wedding dress to show the consequences of abuse. I started out by creating a form chicken wire. I place the dress over top, and then I
covered the dress.
Of a fabric preserving material. I collected magazine articles and pictures from a variety of sources about Harvey Weinstein, Bill Cosby, and R. Kelly, and the hashtag MeToo movement. I tore the pictures and placed them where the women, who were the face of abuse, take center stage, and there is an empty chair at the top to show the unknown victims. As you can see, there's black paint thrown on it, and that was to symbolize the pain I felt from the anger of my own and my mother's abuse. The women who attended the Golden Globe Awards that season wore black fashions in support of all the individuals who had been abused. Broken heart shows distress and other traumatic effects that are the aftermath of violence against women. I hear Eminem featuring Rihanna sing "Love the Way You Lie" over and over again. Overall, the dress reminds me of Judy Chicago's The Dinner Party, whose goal was to end ongoing cycle of omission in which women were written out of the historical record. Also, as you notice on the back, I placed pictures of R. Kelly, and I did not include Bill Cosby. I didn't want to give him any recognition for the damage he caused at one point in their life. The worst statistics are worse for Indigenous and other racially marginalized females. The COVID pandemic has exacerbated the problem. I call the piece our wedding dress because not only was it worn by my mother and myself, who suffered domestic abuse, but also it is an embodiment and representation of every person who wishes to join in a union, a partnership with another human being, with the hope of forever love, support, and devotion, the ultimate bond of trust. The unfortunate fact is that over 50% of marriages dissolve. Many of them end wretchedly one way or another. I am a survivor of abuse from not one but two unsuccessful unions and a childhood ravaged with fear. The consequences of that abuse is far-reaching, and to this day I still feel waves of it. We need to change the horizon on abuse. Protecting and helping those who suffer from it is not a simple task, but programs to help abusers control their anger and figure out better ways to communicate their feelings have been proven to work. Unfortunately, these programs, due to high cost, administer them. Current pandemic has heightened domestic abuse cases. Self-reflection and therapy helped me determine why I made poor choices in my relationships. Unfortunately, I don't think I can answer the question about contributing to the devastating effects of our ecological footprints as artists, but I have a need to address issues in our society through my art, and if that helps others in the process, I think I've done something right. So that is some of my work. And if you have any questions, please don't hesitate to call me. If you take a look here, these are prints of my work. If you're interested, they are $60 unframed or $200 framed. And I do have cards as well that you can buy for $5 each. And I will give 10% of my sales to the Raven Trust in support of this wonderful fundraiser that Maxine has invited me to be part of. And I just want to thank you all for allowing me to share some of my work with you. All right, have a great Christmas. Happy holidays. All right, ciao.